Hi, Mom. Yeah, no, can you pick up Chris after school? Yeah, I'm at the doctor's.
Mrs. Harris?
Describe your symptoms.
Hang on. Stress, headaches, nausea. Well, I work on Saturdays.
And how long has this been?
Equanimity. Balance your lifestyle.
Good morning, Tom Jeffers. Thank you for joining us here in Dallas, Texas.
It's an awesome city.
Well, it is. The weather's pretty good, too, today. Tom Jeffers, I want you guys to know, he's here to give students and families a few preventive steps as those kids head back to those dorm rooms. Tom, there's a lot going on in those dorm rooms that we need to be aware of.
Oh, absolutely. I'm going to tell you, as an entomologist and a proud parent, my daughter's about to return back to her second year of college. It isn't just returning students, but it's also your freshmen. We know that move-in day is a very hectic and chaotic day. You have 1,000 items on your checklist to try to accomplish. One of those things that I incorporate on my checklist is bed bugs, you know, looking and inspecting for those bed bugs in that room. And some of those areas that I'm going to focus in on is going to be around the mattress, box spring, the bed frame itself. But that's one area where, meaning you have to be cognitive of them being in the room. But also they can be brought in, they're transient, so they're roommates. So I'm gonna look at suitcases, boxes, and don't forget the summer stored items that they have there at the college. Make sure you inspect all those areas before you allow that to be entered into the room.
I think you said the word transient, and that's probably the answer, but why are bed bugs such a big concern in college campuses?
Oh, absolutely. The Center for Disease Control, they do consider them a public nuisance issue. They are not known to transmit disease, but they are a significant pest by this Environmental Protection Agency, and we just need to be worried about them biting people, because usually it's the symptoms, and some of those classic symptoms are going to be the reddish-brown spots. They may become swollen, and people will scratch them and irritate them. But also you got to keep in mind it's your bedroom, which is really the most intimate area and the safest part of your house. And so people have that fear, the phobia of the bed bugs in their bedroom, and so they want to make sure they can sleep well at night.
Tom, I want my audience to know that you're, as you said, an entomologist and you're a bed bug expert with more than 33 years of industry experience. Okay, tell us what a bed bug looks like. Most of us don't know.
Sure. Well, the eggs and newly hatched nymphs, they're very small. They're going to be very light, pale in color. But usually what you see is the adult bed bug, which is the same size, shape, and color as an apple seed. That's usually what people will see, as well as the potential bites.
If we find bed bugs in our kids' room, returning or new, what should we do?
That's a great question. One of the things that I would recommend is go ahead and purchase some very good quality, their pillow as well as mattress encasements. That will help keep the bed bugs from getting in their pillow as well as mattresses, as well as keeping stuff off the floor. I know college dorms can get very cluttered, but the less clutter that they have, the better off they are of not having bed bugs. Also be cognitive of loaner books. They can be brought in on books, used books. Sometimes they will go purchase clothing at a used clothing store. If they do that, make sure they wash the clothes as well as dry it on high heat before they actually wear those clothes.
Oh, that's great advice. What are some of the worst cities? You know, we're in Dallas and we broadcast throughout the Texas area, but what's some of the worst cities for bed bugs?
Yes, Detroit is right up there. Then you move into Cleveland, Philadelphia. We get into Los Angeles. But please keep in mind, it can be really in any major metropolitan area is where you'll find the bed bugs more apt. And the what I'm citing here is just internal from customers' inquiries of where we've gotten the questions about bed bugs.
Okay. And if they need to know anything about bed bugs, because we've given them a lot of information, what would you want my audience to know?
Sure. Give us a call, 1-877-TERMINEX, or go to Terminex.com, and from there you can find additional information, preventative as well as what we can do for solutions to control your bed bugs.
Well, you know, we want you to have a safe and happy year with your students returning or going to school. So thanks for listening to this information, because I think it's so important. Tom, I want to thank you very, very much for being so on top of your job. Tom Jeffords, thank you.
My pleasure.